This kingdom is not like the one of ours of Jesus, nor the readers of this gospel experience in Rome. In Rome, citizens matter, and especially wealthy citizens matter more. In Jesus' world, in time, wealthy men and women with wealthy men matter. Yet today in our text, Jesus is talking to people who, as far as Rome is concerned, poor Jews. They don't matter. Luke seems God taking power from the powerful is very clear in the start of his narrative. He had Mary saying, he had brought down the powerful from the thrones and lifted up the lowly. What is this kingdom coming? Jesus replies, watch out for those who say, look, there it is, because the kingdom of God is within you. It's coming, it's going to come as fast as a woman can be swept up or a woman can remain. That's good news for Jesus' audience. And makes perpetually oppressed people feel good to know that God's just reign is swiftly coming. The problem is it doesn't feel like it's true. Rome still has a huge amount of power over the homeland. And the temple is still an ancient Rome. Nothing has changed. So John tells another story. So Jesus tells another story. Jesus tells another story, which is our text this afternoon. This is how it goes. There was a guy somewhere who did not have any reverence for God or humanity. This is interesting because Jesus gave the two commandments. Love God with all your heart, soul, and mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. He did neither. There was a widow who kept coming to him, saying, grant me justice against my opponent. She came. He said no. I mean, why would he say yes? He cared nothing about God or what God wants. And if God wants justice and you believe that at some level you have an obligation to please God, if it's not your life's goal, then you should care about what God wants. And God wants justice, and seeking justice, therefore, should be a part of your agenda. She came the next day. He said no. She came the next day. She said no. I don't know what she wants. But she believed that she is in the right. I don't know where or who her opponent is. Perhaps if she was in the wrong, he would have cared enough to have a hearing and some sort of an explanation. The judge won't even hear her case. And after all, she's a widow. He doesn't care that she had no legal standing to bring a case against anyone. The text does not say. And I was talking to a friend who gave me this idea that because the text didn't say that he wasn't Jewish, perhaps Jesus is pointing out an interesting contradiction about a Jewish person in the first century world that did not respect God or humanity. It's possible. But there's a contradiction between his faith, his identity, and his quest for power. Yes, he comes back. We don't know how many times or how often she came back. Can you see her? She has been told no, and she turned away. How many times do I have to tell you? No! She turns and she comes back again and again. My black and brown brothers and sisters, how many times do the words "no indictment" have to come across the television for this country to let you know you don't belong here? How many more times are those called to protect and serve have to get away with murder? Does the silence about the physical and structural violence against our transgendered brothers and sisters and our saints and our loving family tell them about how much they matter to us? How about our complicity with the structural violence against those with disabilities? What are we saying? Are we saying to women when we think that because they occupy space in the pulpit or other powerful positions in the church that we have somehow solved the issue of sexism and patriarchy in the church? We have been here before. Black folks' fear of police terror didn't begin in August. Stop and frisk was not new. This is a new term for and justified made intimidation from those called to protect and serve legal. We have marched and protested every unjust killing of that body sanctioned by the state. Almost every. It seems like we have a routine. Every time justice is denied and the life is taken. The news comes out. We have a vigil. And a march. That's the saddle. Those who work for justice and want to receive the beloved community of God on earth know this woman all too well. Somebody who does not fit the profile of whose society privileges died, and we say, brought me justice against my opponent. Against my opponent, which sounds awfully a lot like Black Lives Matters. To judges and to citizens and people occupying positions who do not care about God and humanity. Because if they did, they noticed some moral problem about the amount of police violence targeted black and brown bodies, regardless of the situations surrounding their case. Life is being lost disproportionately. And it seems like nothing she does is working. It seems like I'm matching and I'm treating our constant posting of articles on Facebook doesn't get it. We, like this woman, are caught in the middle of a bad story. But there's good news in this. She goes back until the judge is tired of her. He does not have a change of heart. He just wants peace. He says that because this widow keeps bothering me, I will bring her justice. She disrupts the peace and becomes an agitator. We have to become agitators for justice.
Yeah.
Although may not change the hearts of those who control the system, but it will change policies.
Yes.
I have bad news. I mean, as a gospel preacher, I hate to bring bad news. But I have bad news. There are going to be more Renita McBride. There will be more. Lisa Nettles, who was a transgender boy killed in front of a police station. There will be more Mike Mounds. But keep marching, keep preaching about justice.
Yeah.
Keep demonstrating. The text says, I tell you, he will quickly grant justice to them, and yet the human one comes. That when the human one comes, will he find favor? Will he find peace on earth? Will he find that amount of faith on earth? God values all her children. That paper hymn is a hymn that we sing at home church. Hired yet? Made you the fight? Yeah. Right my often? You tonight? Wickedness? Allow me reign? Yeah. Satan's cause may seem to gain. But there is a God that rules above. With a hand of power and a heart of love. If I am right, he'll fight my battle. I shall be free someday. Yes, I do not know how long to be, nor what the future holds for me. But this I know, if Jesus leads me, I shall get home someday. Amen.
Amen. Amen.